You can train and train and train, but 80 minutes is always really beneficial, and against a quality opposition like Wales, it was really good. It was a brilliant hit out for us. We got to see some new players that have come into the squad and get some minutes under the legs for a lot of the girls. You know, it's November was, you know, a good bit away. So I think for both of us it was very beneficial, but for us especially, because, you know, it was our first hit out together since January. In January, Wales had obviously come on the back of a win against Spain. So it was just huge learnings for us, and as Carrie said, you know, you just got it's just a chance to see where you are in terms of your training and what you can fix next weekend before you head into the first round of the championship. I think obviously the publicity side of it, the media side of it, has obviously been huge. It's generated a big following for rugby fans, but also for young girls that are trying to get into the sport or to have role models, that it offers that in terms of the game itself. I think even though bar England, where none of us are professional in that sense, but we now train like we're professionals, and the skill level and fitness and how we execute stuff is at a really big level, and it keeps getting better all the time. So I think because the game is not as physical as the men's, we have to work harder on the skills to try and create good scores, and I think that it makes for good viewing for people. So I think people are generally surprised when they come to see women's rugby at the start. So I just think in general it's just a huge growth of the sport itself. It's just growing year on year, and it's really, really exciting to see it. You know, it's a carrot at the back of your head all the time. I'd be lying to say if I told you, we're not concentrating on it. We're not as such, but you know it's there. It's a huge tournament. It's in your own country. But we'd be doing ourselves a real big disservice if we didn't concentrate on what our jobs at the moment is. And this competition is, you know, we want to go and win it. And we make no bones about that, like any of these girls sitting up here. So, and what it does then is it generates competition within our own squad to try and make that squad for August. So, it's really important for us to concentrate on Scotland and 9 days' time, and that's it really. And I know it sounds a bit cliche, but it's the truth. We can't afford to look. As Sarah said, the competition itself has gone so big, and it's every team now poses a huge big threat. You can't look past anybody else. So that's it. Yeah, I think it was obviously a really good memory 2 years ago, but it's very much in the past. And I think while we cherish it, and you know, it was something really good for us, we can't really dwell on it. And I think last year's tournament, you know, was a big eye opener for us and the standard that we need to reach to. So we're just got to concentrate on ourselves this year and making sure that, you know, we turn up in Broadwood with the goods so that we can try and get the tournament off to a winning start. You've got to prepare to go out and win a match, and that's the most important thing. And I think, you know, as Rory alluded inside, you know, towards the end of the game, it may come into account whether he's kick for a line or kick for posts, try and get a point or deny a point. And but in terms of preparation, nothing changes. You still have to go out and you have to win the game, and that's the most important thing.